Good evening to all of you. I welcome all of you to the online lecture of data structure. Today we are going to cover the topic stack and its applications. Now we'll see what do you mean by stack in data structures. Stack is a linear data structure in which the elements can be added or it can be removed from only one end. It means stack is open from one end and from other end it is closed. So insertion and deletion happens from only one end. That's why the element which is inserted first will be removed last, or the element which is inserted last will be removed first. So it is also known as LIFO data structure. LIFO means last in, first out data structure. Now we'll see there are certain applications of stack in real life also. You have seen a book of stack, where in the library the books are kept one over the another like this. So the book which is kept last will be removed first, and the book which is inserted first will be removed last. Similarly, we can have a book of a stack of coins, where a coin which is inserted last will be removed first. In this manner it works like a last in, first out. Now we'll see the different operation that we can perform on stack data structure. There are three basic operation that we perform on the stack, that is push, pop and display. Push is similar to the insertion operation. Inserting an element into the stack is called as push operation. Then pop operation means deleting an element or removing an element from the stack is called pop operation. Then we have third operation, that is display. All the elements of the stack will be removed from the stack in the reverse order of their insertion. So display operation displays all the elements in the reverse order of their insertion. The pick operation displays the topmost element of the stack always. So there is a pointer called top which always points to the topmost element into the stack. So whenever we perform any insertion operation into the stack, the top pointer must be incremented by one. And it is indicating the location where we want to insert the element into the stack. Similarly, whenever we delete any element from the stack, the top pointer must be deleted, decremented by 1. Now, this is just an example of a stack where if you see the element 0 which was inserted first will be placed at the bottom. The element 1 which is inserted after that is place on top of 0, then next is 2, and then next is 3. Now if I want to push 4 into the stack, it will be placed on top of 3. So whenever we push any element on top of any other element, the top pointer must be incremented by 1. So if you see here in this diagram, top was pointing to 3, now it is pointing to 4. So in insertion operation, always whenever we push any element into the stack, the top pointer must be incremented by 1. So we'll see now the algorithm for push operation. So we begin with the procedure of push stack comma data. If stack is full, we cannot insert any element into the stack. It is very important condition before inserting any value into the stack, and this condition is called as stack overflow condition. So we have to take care of this condition when we implement stack using array. Suppose your stack size is only 5 and you want to insert 6th element into the stack, then it is not possible. You can insert only 5 elements into the stack. So this condition is always checked, stack overflow condition is always checked. Then how do you check the condition? If my stack top pointer reaches to the last size of the array, then I can say that the stack is full. Otherwise we have to increment the top pointer by 1. And at that particular location, we will assign the data provided by the user. And this ends the push operation. Next is pop operation. Again, you see, consider this diagram where there are certain elements into the stacks. And the topmost element is 4. The top pointer is now pointing to 4. If I perform pop operation on this stack, the topmost element will be picked from the stack and it must be deleted from the stack. So 4 will go out of the stack. Once it go out of the stack, the top pointer should be decremented by 1. So if you see here, top was pointing to 4, now it is pointing to 3. So in pop operation, always whenever you delete any element from the stack, the top pointer must be decremented by 1. So this is the algorithm. This is the algorithm for pop operation. Okay. So in case of pop operation also, we have to check one important condition. If your stack is empty, suppose, and you want to perform pop operation on empty stack, then there will be an error message generated by the compiler. You cannot delete any element if the stack is empty. There are no elements and you are performing pop operation, right? So how do you check the stack underflow condition? If stack is empty and if you are performing pop operation, this condition is called as stack underflow condition. If stack is empty, just print a message that stack is empty. If stack is not empty, then go to the else part and pick the topmost element of the stack, print it, and immediately decrement the top pointer by 1. So this is a simple procedure where we delete the element. After deletion of the element, we are decrementing top pointer by 1. Next one is display or peep operation on the stack. The display operation, as we know, display operation of the stack displays all the elements of the stack in the reverse order of their insertion. Again, while writing the poop display operation or peep operation, we have to take care of writing one condition, that is stack underflow. If stack is underflow, we cannot display any element from the stack. If there are no elements for display, we cannot display any element from the stack. So before displaying any element from the stack, we'll check one condition, that is called as stack underflow. And if stack is underflow, we'll print the message the stack is empty. Else, we'll take a for loop, which will start from top element, top index, and it will go to the zeroth index. And every time it will pick the stack element of that index and it will display it. After that, after displaying the element, the index must be decremented by 1. It means I want to display all the elements of this stack from top to bottom. So the display operation result would be 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. So this is the result of this display operation. This is the program to implement stack using array. Whenever we implement any stack using array, we have to define the size of the array, correct? So in the beginning itself, after this declaration of the header files, you'll see here we'll define the size of the array, that is with the help of max variable, and the size of the array here is mentioned is 5. Now to implement stack, we have to define a structure which will create a structure for a stack. So like this, we'll declare a structure. The structure elements are the array which holds the elements of the stack. And there is a pointer which fluctuates up and down in the process of insertion or deletion of elements from the stack. So A is the array which is the part of the stack, and top is the pointer which will fluctuate up and down. Then we declare a variable of the structure S. Through this S structure variable, I can access the array. Similarly, I can access the top pointer with the help of dot operator. Then we'll declare all the functions that are needed into the program, that is push, pop, peep means display function, peek means it displays the topmost element of the stack, and isEmpty is the function which is going to check whether the stack is empty or not. Then there is one more function we have taken in this program, that is full, to check the overflow condition. If stack is full, how do you going to check the function? Check the condition. We are going to check the condition in this function, that is full. Then we are writing this program as a menu driven program, where we are going to display a menu card to the user, and depending upon the options given by the user, we are going to implement the program. So we'll take the option from the user. Here it displays welcome to the stack implementation. While 1 means always true, this program executes till the user presses the option number 4, that is it calls the exit function to stop the program. So this will display a menu card to the user, this printf line. Okay, After that, we are taking the choice from the user with in the variable ampersand choice code, okay? And depending upon the choice entered by the user, we are going to switch to that particular case. If the choice given by the user is 1, it means you want to perform push operation, that is insert operation. When we perform insert operation or push operation onto the stack, we have to first check the overflow condition. Then we are checking the overflow condition by the isFull function. If it is true, then we'll directly write the message that stack is full. Else, we'll take the element from the user and we'll call the push function to push that element into the stack and we'll stop. Now in case 2, we are going to perform the deletion operation or pop operation on the stack. So before performing any pop operation on the stack, we are going to check one condition here, that is called stack underflow condition or isEmpty condition. If this is true, we'll print the message that stack is empty. Otherwise, we are going to call the pop function. In else part, we are going to call pop function. Then break and stop. Case 3 is the case for display operation. In display operation, again, we have to check the condition, that is stack underflow condition. And we'll check it by this function is empty. If stack is empty, there are no elements for display. We'll print that message stack is empty. Otherwise, we'll call pip function for display the elements from the stack and break. And then we have another function in case 4, that is the topmost element. So get size will get the size of the stack and display it. In case 5, we'll stop the program with the help of exit function. If the user enter any invalid choice, it must go to the default option and here will print one message that it is invalid choice. So this ends the basic structure of the main program, and then we'll start writing the push function. In push function, we will take a value from the user and it will be assigned at the location of s dot a of plus plus s dot top equal to n. Now, what is the meaning of this line? It is a combination of two lines. Here, the first operation that will be executed will be plus plus s dot top. So, it means the top pointer will be incremented first before assigning the value n to the stack. In pop operation, if you see here, it will display the element, topmost element from the stack. After that, this is post decrement operator. It means after displaying the topmost element from the stack, the top pointer is decremented by 1. Then we have another function called as isEmpty function. How do you check the underflow condition for the stack? If s dot top equals to minus 1, in case of array, minus 1 means it is pointing at index minus 1 and it is not pointing to 0, it means it is empty. Okay. So if s dot top equals to minus 1, we'll say return 1, it means true, otherwise return 0 if it is false. Similarly, to check overflow condition, we have another function called as isFull function, and to check whether the stack is overflow or not, we are going to check it with the help of the condition if s dot top equals to max minus 1, that is total size of the array minus 1. If it is reached to the last index of the array, we will return 1, otherwise we will return 0. Then there is another function called as pip function, which is equivalent to the display function. Before displaying element from the stack, we have to first check the condition, that is stack underflow condition, and we will check it with the help of this function isEmpty. It will print a message that stack is empty if this one condition is true. Otherwise, we will display all the elements of the stack with the help of for loop. We will initialize I equal to s dot top and it will go till 0, and every time we will decrement I value by 1. So, for integer I equals to s dot top, semicolon I greater than equals to 0, semicolon I minus minus is the line for displaying the elements from the stack. So this for loop is responsible for displaying the elements of the stack. Inside the for loop, we are going to write the line, that is printf percentage d, and it will pick the element from the stack, that is with the help of s dot a of I. So every time it will pick the topmost element. After displaying that element, it will decrement the value of I. This process will be continued till I becomes 0. So it will display all the elements of the stack from top element to the 0th element. Pick function displayed the topmost element of the stack. So this statement will going to display with the help of s dot a of s dot